Hello, greetings, church. I miss you so much. I can't wait till we can gather together again, but we're working on that. But one thing that's come out of all of this is what I call pandemic humor. And someone sent me a text this morning that said, four ways we can come out of this thing: a monk, a hunk, a chunk, or a drunk. Well, I hope there's some other options. But I think the truth behind it is that we will come out of this having been changed. There's no way we can stay the same after this experience, because it's been a challenging, obviously, experience. And the Bible talks about that as wilderness experiences, the feeling of lost or being disoriented or abandoned even. Yet most of us have had experiences like that, when you're sitting in the waiting room wondering how your loved one is doing, or, you know, wander around a parking lot because you can't find your car, you can't remember where you parked it because you've got this pink slip in your hand. So unexpected. Or maybe hearing the door slam behind you because that relationship, well, there's been irreparable damage. Those are wilderness places, and that's what the Bible talks about when we are feeling that we are at such a difficult place. And wilderness takes lots of different forms. But the only way to be sure that you are in a wilderness time is when you look around for what normally you count on to save your life, and it's not there anymore. There's nothing. No food, no personal power, no special protection, no security. And it's not a place we want to be, these wilderness times. It's not a place we'd ever seek out. It's a place that we would avoid if ever we could. And yet there can be something that happens during these times. You see, what if the wilderness is a place where we begin to realize who we really are and what we really want to do with our life, what our life is really about? You know, what if the desert is where, at this point when we are most vulnerable, we are most able to, well, be fed and led and held by God? I heard it said one time that the spiritual life has three basic parts of that journey: the orientation, when we first come to know who God is; the disorientation, which would be this desert time; and then the reorientation. And maybe that's what we face as we move through this, a time to be reoriented as God's people. One of my favorite preachers, Barbara Brown Taylor, speaks of it this way. She says, I guess that could sound like bad news, this wilderness, but she says, I don't think it is. I think it is good news, because even if no one ever wants to go there, and even if those of us who end up there want to get out as soon as possible, the wilderness is still one of the most reality-based, spirit-filled, life-changing places a person can be. So are we in the wilderness during this pandemic? And if so, might it be a time when you can reorient your trust and your faith in the power and the love of God? I hope you are blessed.